Okay, let's discuss the solution for handling the first two signals, sig term and sig kill, so that you can do the other two yourself. For the demonstration, I have already written the code so that I'll explain it to you here. This is the code, and the first thing was including the library signal.h. So this is what I've done here. I have included the library. And the second thing I've done is this. I have included the prototype of what? Of my custom signal handler. This is my custom signal handler, which I will define later on in the program. And this is what I have passed it. So just keep this name in your mind. This is the name of my custom signal handler. And then I have started the main program. First of all, what I've done is I have registered my custom signal handler with the kernel. How should we do that? This is actually the third step that I taught you in the algorithm slide. So what I've done is I have called the function signal, and this function signal is written in this library. I have called this function, and what it's doing is I have passed the first parameter is sig term. The first parameter is actually the name of the signal for which you are registering this custom signal handler. So you are telling the kernel, if this particular signal, if sig term comes, then execute my custom signal handler, which is this. If sig term comes, then execute this function. And in the second statement, I've done the same thing. If sig kill comes, then execute this statement. So for now, I have written the same custom signal handler for both these signals. You will see that in the definition of this signal handler, that why I've done that. Actually, this custom signal handler is actually handling two signals at a time. So those two signals are sig term and sig kill. And we can do that in one function. It's possible. Okay. The next thing is right here, you can see I have written an infinite loop. That infinite loop is it will run when I is greater than 0 and I is continuously increasing. So it's not decreasing. So this is obviously an infinite loop. And this loop is just printing the value of I. So this is just here so that we have an infinite loop. So the process is busy, and then we will send it these two signals and see whether this process handles it or ignores it. Or what does it do with it? So we will see that in the output. Okay, this was our main program. Now let's see the definition for this particular function. And this function is actually what? Custom signal handler. Let's see its definition. Okay, this is the definition of our custom signal handler, and we have named it my signal handler. You saw that in the previous slide. Okay, what's it doing? First of all, I have written two if statements. So it's checking if this particular parameter, if that is equals to sig term, that means it will execute this for sig term. And if that parameter is equals to sig kill, this thing will be run. So this signal handler is actually handling two signals. And if sig term comes, this will be run. If sig kill comes, this will be. So what we have done is, if sig terms comes, I have just printed a statement sig term and another statement my handle with signal, and I have printed whatever is there written in the variable my signal. I've just printed it. Nothing else. Nothing complicated or too tough. And the other one, sig kill, I have just printed sig kill signal receive. And now what we'll do is, we will run the program and we'll see, in the case of sig term, does these lines appear or not? If these lines appear, it means the signal was caught. The signal was caught and the program came to this point. And in the case of sig kill, we will see whether this line appear or not. If it appears, that means it was caught. If these lines do not, this line actually does not appear, that means sig kill was not caught. And we'll see that in the output. So let's see the output of this particular program. Okay, so for the output, for running this program, I have run this. You can see two terminals right here. The first terminal is this, and the second terminal is this. So I have run this program in this terminal, the first one, the one that is in the background. So you can see these numbers. And what are these numbers? These are actually these numbers, this printf line. We were printing actually the values of I. So you can see those here. So these numbers are actually the values of I. So you can see that this program is running in an infinite loop and just printing the values of I. Now what I did was I opened up another terminal and I just grabbed, I just searched for my process right here. Okay, one more thing. The name of my file was signalhandling.c. This is the name of my code, my C file, signalhandling.c. Keep that in mind. So I've written the line with which I compiled my program for you right here. GCC space dash O, signal handling space, signalhandling.c. So this is the name of my C file and this is the name of my exe file. And this was the name of C file I just showed you right here. This was the C file. This was the C file. This, the name was signalhandling.c. So that's what I have written, which I have written right here. Okay, now what I did was I searched for signal handling. Okay, you can notice one thing right here is I have not written .c. So I am not searching for the C file, not for this file. Why? Because we only search for processes here. So this is not a process, and I explained this before. This is not a process. This is a program. This is the set of instructions, the code file. While this is the execution state of this code file. So the execution state of a coding file of a program is a process. So this is our process actually, and I am searching for this. That's why I have written signal handling here, not signalhandling.c. This is a very important point. So I have searched for signal handling, the process, and then I came up with three different sets of PID. So first PID is this, the second is this, and third is this. And again, we have to be smart here and see which one we are interested in. So the last one is grep. Obviously, we are not interested in this one because this is actually the same process, this one, which initiated, which gave us these results. So we are not interested in the PID, which is showing grep at its end. And the first one, you can see at the end of the first one, signalhandling.c. So this is actually the C file. We are not interested in that either. What we want is, we want this. This is, you can see right here, ./, and then the name of your process. This process, which we started. So this is the one we are interested in, and the ID is 3201. So this is the PID that we need, and we will use this PID and send it two different signals, sick term and sick kill. Let's see what happens. So when we send sick term, what happens is right here I have written kill dash 15. So dash 15 is used for sick term, and then the ID 3201, which we just searched. So this is the command, and when I pressed enter, you can see right here the loop was running. The loop was on the 399th iteration. What happened? Sick term is displayed, and then my handle was signal. This line is displayed, which we printed in our code. So that means sick term is caught. And here you can see 399 is the value of I, and the next value of I is this 400. That's written here, and the next one is 401. So this is written here. Now you can notice one thing. The loop was running, the signal was caught, but this program chose to ignore this signal because it was busy in something, it was doing something, and it did not choose to terminate. So sick term can be caught and it can be ignored. So this signal was actually ignored and the program continued its normal execution. The program did not stop. So that's why you are seeing the number 401. The program did not stop. The loop continued. So this means right here we sent the signal sick term and our process ignored sick term. Now we will send it the next signal, which is sick kill, and we'll see whether this is ignored or not. So the next command is kill space dash 9, and I told you previously that dash 9 is used for sick kill. This is the command for sick kill. So kill space dash 9, and then the same PID, process ID 3201, and let's see here. So you can see the program was on the 553rd iteration, and it just got killed. It didn't it was not even caught. Why? Because in the code of SIGKIL, we displayed something. What did we display? We displayed SIGKIL signal received. This is what we displayed in the printf right here. But this thing has not appeared here. That means this signal, SIGKIL, was not caught. Nothing happened. It just killed this program instantly without letting it save its state or giving it any option to ignore or continue. So it was just killed. So this is it. I think you are now able to write code for the other two signals, as I have solved the first two for you. So I think it's easy. These are my references. I hope to see you next time.